Much, ladies and gentlemen. We are the Jazz Ensemble of West Virginia State University, and on behalf of President Hazel W. Carter, Vice President Charles Byers, the faculty, staff, and students of West Virginia State University, we'd like to thank Commissioner Randall Reed Smith and the Division of Culture and History for including us in tonight's Collegiate series here at the Cultural Center. We're going to provide you with about an hour of jazz from all the different styles and periods of jazz history, and we hope you enjoy. The first tune that we played for you this evening was entitled Blues in the Closet. It was a hit by the late, great Oscar Pettiford, a jazz bassist of great fame. And we'll move on now into some big band literature for you. This is Pennsylvania 6-5000.
Thank you.
Thank you, ladies and gentlemen. One of the most interesting things to listen to in the big band era were the crooners that sang along with the big bands, and we have our own version of such this evening. We're going to be performing tonight a tune made popular by Frank Sinatra entitled "They Can't Take That Away From Me." And to help us do that, would you please welcome to the stage Mr. Robert Slack.
Keep me loving you, and with your permission, may I list a few. The way you wear your hat, the way you sip your tea, the memory of all that. Oh no, they can't take that away from me. The way your smile just beams, the way you sing off key, the way you haunt my dreams. Oh no, they can't take that away from me. We may never, never meet again on the bumpy road in love. Still I'll always, always keep a memory of the way you hold your knife, the way we danced until three, the way you changed my life. Oh no, they can't take that away from me. They can't take that away from me. We danced till three, the way you changed my life. Oh no, they won't take that away from me.
Vocalists were indeed intriguing figures with the big bands, and one of the most interesting things that vocalists did were the ballads of the big bands. And we'd like to introduce you to a little bit of ballad this evening in the form of a very famous one, "My Funny Valentine." And we're going to feature our other vocalist on this piece this evening. So please welcome her to the stage, Ms. Chelsea Price.
Thank you.
Thank you, ladies and gentlemen. Please, another hand, Bob Slack and Chelsea Price. We'd like to switch gears just a little bit and look at a different period of jazz history. This piece is entitled Mercy, Mercy, Mercy.
Thank you.
Thank you again, ladies and gentlemen. You've already met our vocalists, but I'd like for you to meet the rest of the band as we progress through the evening. So we're going to introduce a section at a time between tunes, starting with our saxophone section. On lead alto, Mr. Chris Dillon. On lead tenor, Mr. Chris Itzen. Second tenor, Ms. Emily Modishard. And over here on Barry Sax, Ben Millie-Nide. We'd like to play another ballad for you featuring one of our saxophonists, Mr. Chris Dillon, and this is the immortal ballad, Lover Man.
Thank you.
Thank you, ladies and gentlemen. Please, another hand, Mr. Chris Dillon. I'd like to introduce to you now our trombone section, beginning with the lead trombone player in the center, Mr. K.W. Morrison. Second trombone, no relation, John Morrison. Third trombone, Mr. Josh Wiley. And our bass trombonist, Mr. Tyler Mullins. We'd like to go back for you now to the big band era and play a little bit of Glenn Miller for you. This is Moonlight Serenade. A group like this that has this type of instrumentation, it's It's a wonderful thing to be able to play the music of the big bands, but it's also a wonderful thing to play a few more modern type styles with this type of instrumentation. So we'd like to do that very thing for you now and introduce you to a little bit of what we call funk. This piece, before we play it, I'm getting ahead of myself, and let me introduce our trumpet section to you, beginning with our lead trumpet player in the center, Mr. Trace Anderson. Second trumpet, Mr. Ken Amick. Third trumpet, Mr. Micah Peggs. And also on the third book, Mr. Justin Craney. And covering the fourth part, Ms. Candace Chin. Now we'd like to play a little bit of funk for you. This piece is a very, very different style than what you just heard before, no doubt. And
thank you. bless you so much.
Thank you. Thank you very much. The heart of a big band, the heart of any kind of jazz ensemble, is the rhythm section. It's what keeps pushing us forward and laying down the foundations that allow all these wonderful improv solos to happen and all those kinds of things. So we'd like to introduce our rhythm section to you at this point. On guitar, Mr. Rick Perdue. On bass, Mr. John Ingram. On drums, Mr. Mark Price. And on auxiliary percussion, Mr. Matt McKinney. We'd like to go back to the big band style again for you, and we're going to perform a piece for you called Barn Burner, and that requires just a little bit of explanation. A barn burner in the days of the big bands meant a tune that was played just as fast as you could possibly play it, and that's what we're going to attempt to do for you this evening. So we're going to hold on to our seats, and we hope you do the same. This is Barn Burner.
We'll be right back.
Thank you again, ladies and gentlemen. Before we play our last tune for you this evening, I'd like to just tell you just a little bit, if I could, about the jazz ensemble at West Virginia State University. Something was mentioned in the opening remarks about our ensemble, and I'd hate to repeat anything, but I think it's important that you know where these students come from and what their dedication to this style of music is. On the stage, you see majors who are majoring in music, those who are majoring in other areas from across the university and the community and technical college, and they all come together on Thursday nights, or Thursday afternoons, I should say, at 4 o'clock, and rehearse this style of music. Most of them are accomplished musicians in other styles of music, I dare say all of them are, and play in all of the ensembles that we have at West Virginia State. But their dedication to this style of music is truly inspiring. This is a truly American art form. Jazz music is different than classical music in that it takes a heart and a soul to play classical music, obviously, but it takes a different kind of heart and soul to perform this particular style of music. A lot of the things that you've heard here tonight are written down on the page, but many of those things are not. And these young students are not just performers, they're not just instrumentalists, they're composers as well, because they're composing these solos and these things that they do at the moment, in the moment, and they're living in the moment musically. Thanks to their dedication and their hard work, they've been able to do a great number of things musically, not the least of which is a good number of these students you see on the stage tonight were part of our tour a year ago for 9 days in Austria, and we were privileged to play in 3 cities. We played in Vienna, Graz, and Salzburg, and were able to work with teachers from the European Center for Jazz Studies in Graz, and it was a tremendous experience. And without these young people and their dedication to jazz, that would not be possible for West Virginia State University or any other institution of higher learning. So if you would, please join me in saluting these young people for their dedication. Again, we thank you. We thank the Commissioner and the Division of Culture and History for having us here this evening. And we're going to close out with one last tune for you tonight. This piece is by a famed jazz composer named Dominic Spera. It's in the funk groove again, and it's a great way to end a program. This is called Straight Ahead and Strive for Tone.